In a lot of cases, some people just don't know, you know, how to properly care for, you know, their feet. And people's case that have toenail fungus and, you know, really bad calluses, it's easy to just kind of let that go. It can be painful and it needs to be addressed because our feet are very, very, very important. You can get infections, you know, you can get wounds. There's a lot of things that can happen with the foot if you don't treat them properly. All right, so the next patient we have here, his name is Michael. We're gonna get Michael on the call here and see how Michael's doing. How you doing, guys?
Hi, Hi. Dr. Brad.
How are you guys doing with quarantine? You guys are fellow Jerseys, right?
Yes.
Awesome. Yeah, I'm in New Jersey also, so we're close.
Oh, wow.
Well, my parents were born and raised in Elizabeth.
Right around my neck of the woods. Family.
Hey.
Jersey strong, baby. It looks like you're at home with some family there, so you're quarantining with somebody. That's good. And that's your sister?
Yes, sir. Rosie.
All right. Awesome. Hey, look, I'm going over your case. What are you doing over there?
I was working on a farm for like 18 years as a wrangler.
Okay.
And I always used to wear moccasins in the morning, and I had caught thrush.
Usually thrush is in the mouth, right?
Yeah, but when I worked on a farm, the horses got it. And okay. The moccasins, when I used to work early in the morning, it just used to seep right through. And I never thought anything about it until I started getting that smell.
Oh.
I personally think it smells like dead carcass, to be honest with you.
Oh, my gosh.
For the past 15 years, I haven't been able to take my socks off, take my boots off, go to the lake, nothing like that.
Right.
And my nails are terrible. It looks like I get hanged from a tree.
He could river dance with his toenails. It's the most disgusting thing ever.
How about I see it through the camera here so I can get a pretty good idea? And this is always challenging, so try to get that computer rearranged so I can see the foot.
Look at them.
Yeah, I can see your nails.
Look at the bottom of them.
Okay. Just keep it right there.
It's like Betty Davis eyes with Freddy Krueger feet.
They're definitely in the need of some care.
Yes, sir. When they hit the tip of my boot, they start curling under. It's terrible.
When your toenails do curve under like that, when they're in shoes, that has to be awful. That has to be like knives going in the front of your foot. That has to be rough, man.
That's exactly what it feels like.
What's your right foot look like?
It's the same, but the toes go a different way on this side.
May I see your heel?
Wow.
They peel, they burn, and it's really hard for me to walk sometimes.
And they smell.
I have my work ahead of me with those puppies.
Well, these puppies are out of control.
I'm gonna river dance.
All right, cool. Very good. Michael, I know you think you have thrush, but what I've seen and what I'm looking at here, it's called onychomycosis. And onychomycosis is a really bad fungal infection of the nails that's causing them to grow up and down and become very long. You also have extreme callus buildup on the bottom of your feet. And sometimes that can be bacteria and different things get in there and infections. You know, other times it can just be the color of the socks that you're wearing. You know, the good news is there's a fix. You come see me. You know, I take out my tools, I take out my 15 blade, I really debride that callus down nice and low, and then we'll get that treated properly so it doesn't keep building up on you like this. Now, as far as your nails are concerned, what I'm gonna need to do is I'm gonna take out my nail nippers, I'm gonna really go across them nice and smooth so it looks like you have normal appearing nails. After all that, it's up to you. You're gonna have to apply some topicals, you're gonna have to apply some creams to really hammer this out so this infection doesn't exist anymore.
Oh, I thank you so much. I'll never forget this.
So next step, we're gonna see you in my office. So we're gonna get you river dancing comfortably and definitely rocking out. It's a great first step. You seem like a ball of fun. Your sister seems awesome, Rosie, and seem like a good team player there.
We're good people.
I can see that.
We're hillbillies.
Yeah.
But we're Purdy.
Look, we'll bring your purdy butt to my office, and you know we'll see you there, and we'll take care of you, boss. All right.
Thank you so much, Dr. Brad. I really appreciate this.
Hi, Russell. Can you hear me?
I can. How are you?
Hi. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Can you start with what happened or how you were born?
Sure. Well, when I was born, I had webbed toes and also clubbed feet. And if that wasn't enough, when I was born, my feet were also like split right down the middle, kind of like as if it were a hoof, I guess you would say.
Did they ever give you a formal diagnosis for that? Because like you said, webbed feet, clubbed feet. Did they ever mention a term, extradactyly?
Not that I'm aware of. You know, as soon as I was born, they rushed me off to another hospital and they actually wired my feet together. And it was like both feet, you know, they had to wire together.
Got it. Have you tried any surgeries?
I did have an extra toe in there somewhere on my left foot, but it was kind of growing underneath my big toe. So I did go to the doctor so whenever I put my foot down, I would be stepping on that toe. And so I went to the doctor and I'd asked if they'd amputate it, and they did.
So if you could tilt the camera down just a little bit so I can see the foot.
Yes, this is the left foot here.
Okay.
Let me try to slide this around.
Wow. Russell, I don't think I've ever seen toes like this before. So the left fourth toe, that was amputated about 10 years ago, right?
That's one that was right here. Yes, correct.
Okay. And the third toe never really quite develops because it's fused to that second toe.
Correct.
Okay. And then the second toe and the first toe are webbed.
Correct.
Okay. If you could point to one spot that hurts the most, could you do that?
Absolutely. Everything is kind of right around in here.
Okay.
Where I get a lot of pain. And that's where all the metatarsal bones come up and they fuse to that one bone that's going across the top right here. I really feel a lot of burning sensation.
When you describe a burning sensation or a shooting sensation, those are all nerve pains. Could you put your hand on the big toe? On, there you go. And then try and stabilize the shaft of the metatarsal bone, like the middle portion of your foot?
Well, you know, my toes don't really bend.
Okay, that was my question. They don't bend at all.
Just the top knuckle right there, and that's it. You know,
so okay, does the bunion bend at all? Does the bunion, can you bend that area?
Nope, this is it. As far as my range of motion goes, this is all I have.
Okay. And so because you have the fused area there, it could be compressing on the nerve that's running right underneath there.
Okay.
Does the bunion hurt you at all in any way, shape, or form?
Absolutely it does. There's pain that's right here at the bunion, at the joint, when I walk at times as well.
Okay. Well, great. Well, thank you for showing me that the left foot. Let's take a look at the right foot.
All right.
Okay. All right.
So this one, I really don't have any pain in this foot at all.
And no nerve burning pains on that area either, right?
No, I don't feel any pain with this one. I don't need to wear flip-flops, I'm okay.
Okay.
You know, I've got pretty normal range of motion, everything feels good.
Okay, this is called extradactyly. This is a congenital birth defect that unfortunately, just your bones and your feet do not develop normally at all. Let's focus on the left foot. Thank you for your x-rays. Because you had this deformity as a child and that you had it formed closed, that's the portion that's going to be addressed because that's what needs to go.
Okay.
So in order to do that, it would definitely need surgery in order to just get rid of the bony area here. You did say that this bunion was a source of pain also.
Yes.
So if we were to address the bunion, we'd also simultaneously would have to address the webbing of the digits. Now, web digits are difficult to heal in general. What I can offer you is basically a fixing of this bunion here. But I would offer it in the sense of a fused big toe, because what I don't want to have happen is this big toe not be fused in the correct position for walking. So I would most likely recommend that we fix your bunion by fusing this big toe after we desyndactylize the web toes.
Okay, no, that'd be fine. I mean, my toes don't bend anyway.